All right, so let's talk about gesture drawings, shall we? Gesture drawings are absolutely some of my favorite to do because they run completely counterintuitive to my usual way of working. That is to say, I am in many ways extremely uptight in the way I draw. And that is to say, the second I put the pencil down, I want to get it right. And that's really not how gesture drawings should be. The whole point of gesture drawings is presumably to capture a gesture. And the key to that, as I was taught in my not all that impressive college, is to not give it that much thought and not be afraid to do a lot of scribbling. And that's actually something that I still struggle with. It's something I still have to practice. But for whatever reason, I just felt really compelled today to demonstrate what it is I'm talking about. Because A, it's a lot of fun. And B, I just think as an exercise, allowing yourself to really just scribble without giving it that much thought. And without worrying about getting it right, gives you the kind of freedom that you need to sort of really think creatively. So that you can capture the motion of what it is you're going for. And hopefully the end result is something that has a little thing we animators like to call life. And I'm using Spider-Man here as an example. Now you'll notice I'm doing just a slightly more cleaned up version of my already very scribbly version. And that's intentional because if you work really hard on something and then determine, oh, this isn't exactly, what I wanted or I want to change something. It's a big deal if you've been slaving over it for hours and hours. Whereas if I have to start over on this, it's just not a big deal at all. And so in addition to being a good way of practicing gesture drawing, it also becomes a very zen experience. And of course, I chose Spider-Man because Spider-Man has got to be one of the very best characters ever in terms of drawing and gestures. So you can kind of see where I'm going with this. And you can also hear that I'm still getting over a cold. But yeah, that's kind of the whole point. Now, is this a perfect drawing? Is this a perfect pose? Is there anything perfect about this? No. But this is a drawing that lets me look at it and go, is this anywhere near what I want to do? And if the answer is yes, you move on to the next stage and make it a little bit cleaner. If the answer is no, you start all over again. And allow yourself to be just as sketchy and sloppy as you were the first time. Really just trying to capture the mood of what it is you're drawing more than trying to do anything that counts as even remotely realistic. Anyway, that's it. This is me talking about gesture drawings. If you found this helpful, be sure to like it, share it, and I'll do more. Ziggy zigga, party people.